Hello, I'm Edgar Miranda.
The lore of the new gods is plagued with deception, treachery, and sorrow. And even Darkseid, who became the most powerful member of the royal court of Apocalypse, and maybe the universe, after betraying his brother and robbing him of his birthright, preferred schemes over brute strength. Because even gods know that
when you play the Game of Thrones, you win or you die. There is no middle ground.
Good people of YouTube, welcome. If this is your first time here, please know I've been expecting you. Click subscribe, hit the bell, and take a seat. Let me entertain you. Fresh from the Infinity Pit, Darkseid's first act was going to be a long-awaited revenge on his mother, but when she revealed knowing that the figure in front of her, who had mastered the Omega Force, was Uxas, not her firstborn Drax, it became clear to him that despite the grudge he held after millennia of cruelty, it would serve him more to keep her on the throne and rule beside her. At least for now. And the opposite would have been the fate of Tigra, the woman his mother imposed on him as wife, if it wasn't for the heir she carried in her womb. And as fate would have it, according to prophecy, this heir was destined to be his father's undoing, a destiny some thought made Orion, the rightful successor to the Apocalypse throne over Darkseid's firstborn son Kalevak from his first marriage with the only woman he had ever and would ever love when he was Uxas. And this sibling rivalry would be legendary, but not in the most apparent way. Yet the tangles of heirs and destinies would have to unravel later, because there were more immediate concerns. Despite the fragile peace between Apocalypse and her sister world, Darkseid convinced his uncle Steppenwolf to own a random hunt for new gods of New Genesis, hiding from him his real plans. The raiders fell upon unsuspecting victims, and in the struggle, one of them was struck, but before Steppenwolf could finish the job, Darkseid intervened. His uncle, distrustful of him, knowing him to be the plotter, like his mother, the queen, suspected there was much more to this simple day's hunt, and little did he know how right he would turn out to be, because that day, Isaiah of New Genesis lost his wife. And this event, engineered by Darkseid, marked the start of the war between New Genesis and Apocalypse, a conflict that lasted hundreds of years, and so destructive that many planets did not see the end of it. It was during this long period that Darkseid found out that his first wife, the sorceress Sully, who Hegra disapproved of, thinking she would corrupt her son, was poisoned by none other than his friend the Sat, at the Queen's command. And ironically, it's because of this event that Darkseid, who during his time with Sully did come to question his quest for the throne, decided to pay his mother in kind. And when Darkseid ruled supreme over Apocalypse, two unexpected events, a proposition of peace from New Genesis, directly from the High Father, a new god who was once a man named Isaiah, but that's a story for another day. And the acceptance of that pact by the Dark God himself. To guarantee peace, there would be an exchange. The High Father would send his son to be raised in Apocalypse, and Darkseid would send his son to New Genesis. And the ending is the beginning. The saga of the new gods starts here, and the fourth world comes to Earth. This is the story as it was expanded upon by many great writers and artists throughout the years. From the original creation by Jack Kirby, it would later be retconned in the New 52, where Yuga-Khan was the last of the old gods and father of both Uxas and Isaiah, the former who masterminded the events that led to the destruction of the old gods and his ascension to Darkseid. But this is what both iterations have in common. Orion, Darkseid's son with Tigra, sent to New Genesis, embraced the teachings of the High Father, and became that world's biggest champion. And Scot-Free, the son of the High Father, raised in Apocalypse, would one day escape and become Earth's hero, Mr. Miracle. Yet this was a price Darkseid paid gladly. He always expected Scott to escape, as that would mark the end of the Pact and the start of a new war, because the only thing the Pact meant to Darkseid was time. Time to find his great prize.
Anti-life is found, Asad, and we will stop at nothing to possess it.
Thank you for watching. If you like this video, maybe check another one.
I shouldn't.
Come on.
Do it.
See you next time.
I have come to enlighten you to the great darkness.